He qualified, he was terrific on Tuesday, but boy, was he sensational tonight. The performance of his life.
Well, I'm best known as an Olympic figure skater for the United States, I think. I have a very loud public persona. I'm a very celebrated part of the gay community. I'm a singer, I'm an author, I am an athlete, I'm a husband, I'm a father to a beautiful puppy, and I have a very blessed and happy life.
Maybe he is more performer than competitor, but he is a breath of fresh air, and it's pure theater every time he's on the ice.
The longer that I've been in the sport of figure skating is very revealing and eye-opening, because while I don't know what I was born to do, many people say that I was born to skate. And that simply comes from the fact that I grew up in Amish country in Pennsylvania, and we didn't have ice rinks. We didn't really have a lot of exposure to culture. It was one of those towns where in the winter, if we had a really bad storm, we couldn't get out of our town for 2 weeks. And that's where I come from, cows and buggies and all of that. So we had no exposure to lots of arts and culture, lots of different sports. You either were a football player, a soccer player, baseball, or you worked on a farm. I dreamt of doing something that I wanted to do and not just being told what to do. And that came to me at a very young age. And oddly enough, one winter, my cornfield behind my house froze over, and I'd been watching figure skating on television. So my parents bought me a pair of used ice skates, and I went out there and I skated on this frozen cornfield. And I was weaving in and out of the stalks, but I immediately took to it. I immediately understood my balance and how that I could stand up on ice and these tiny razor blades. And from there, 4 years later, I was a junior world champion. Shortly after that, I was the American champion 3 times. I was competing in my first Olympics, and it all happened very organically and very, very much with pomp and circumstance. My role models have varied a lot over the years, but the first person to ever really catch my interest in figure skating was Oksana Bayul when she won the 1994 Olympics, and all of America, and I think most of the world, was glued to Nancy Kerrigan and Tanya Harding. For me, running around my house supporting this Ukrainian orphan in pink and marabou and going against the American favorite, Nancy Kerrigan, was wild. But she had a way of combining art and sport and showbiz and costuming and just creating this beautiful moment where it was something that I'd never seen before. For me, figure skating is showbiz. Yes, it's a sport. Yes, it's an Olympic sport. It's very serious. It's rigorous. Our lives as athletes are sometimes forgotten because of how glamorous figure skating seems to be. The costuming, the drama, the music, the fact that, you know, a 15-year-old girl can portray anything from Broadway show tunes to Tosca to a very heavy Russian Rachmaninov or Tchaikovsky. That's an incredible part of what I do and a part of my sport, because we get to play so many different people. Every year, every week, we get to do something different and unique, and putting the whole look together with the costuming and the music is definitely a huge thing that attracted to me to figure skating to begin with. Oksana Bayul, after her, Michelle Kwan and her artistry, Irina Slutskaya, Yevgeny Plushenko, a great Russian Olympic champion. I was inspired so much by not just the jumps or just the spins, but the entire image and the entire picture. I was 21 in my first Olympics, and I wanted to do something that would make a statement. And I was working with the famed coach Tatiana Tarasova at the time. She was training her group in Connecticut, which wasn't so far away from me, and I trained with her every summer. And she was a huge supporter of mine and somebody that could push me through art and through sport to be better and to improve myself. And I wanted to be around that energy as much and as often as possible. And she came to me with the idea that I would play this dying swan. So we started working on it. Within 2 days, I was obsessed with the music. I could hear every lilt of the cello in the piece, every sort of on classical recordings, there's this kind of breath behind the music. And I acquainted myself with everything that was going on behind the music, on top of it, under it. And, you know, I really fell in love. It was a circus, but it was the most beautiful, well-thought-out circus of my career. Sitting and watching the Olympics, you don't realize how huge it is. And it took me my first Olympics to learn that, so that I was prepared for it my second Olympics, but we created that moment. And that's what figure skating is all about. That's what I'm in it for, is to create those moments where everyone just sits and you can hear a pin drop. Being gay never turned into something that I was ashamed of. It never grew seven heads and was something that I had to slay. It just was something that I was. The same as that I'm white, the same that I'm American, the same that I have green eyes. That's what being gay means to me. As a sportsman, I've learned to be competitive in every aspect of my life. It could be Olympic figure skating, it could be singing a song and outselling somebody else, it could be writing a book, or being on television, or having more Twitter followers, or even downloading a game, if it's Scrabble or something, on my iPod or my phone. I aim to be the best in the whole world at everything that I do. So that, I think, is how I was able to be successful in figure skating, because I can balance this crazy competitive side of me with the art and the sparkle, I guess I could say. The last Olympics in Vancouver, where I skated better than I ever have in my entire life, and I made that aha moment for myself. I was on display in front of billions of people around the world, and I was able to show everything that I am and everything that I've worked for. And it sounds very cheesy and almost like a person that has ever won a medal thing to say, but that moment in my life is worth 100 Olympic gold medals.